Welcome back to the Habs podcast, guys. Welcome back to a brand new video. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Make sure you give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to this channel.
Hello, welcome to a new podcast. This is our fourth episode, so let's start by talking about the Habs week. So I think we started this week with like in an unbelievable way because we beat the Colorado Avalanche, a power horse team, but then it got a bit more rough. And this weekend, we lost to the Bruins 9-4 in a blowout. And we also lost to the Sens 2 days ago, 6th, by a score of 6-2. So, like, and we also beat the Devils. Also, that was Wednesday, 3-2. So, what did you think of this week overall for our Habs?
Yeah, you know, it was started really well. Like, we won two impressive wins, man. Like, versus the Colorado Avalanche and New Jersey, like, two good, really good teams. That was pretty impressive.
I was really surprised.
Yeah. And, like, also, like, obviously, losing versus Ottawa sucks. You know, I think it was maybe because of the back-to-back game. And, obviously, we know yesterday versus Boston, it was very brutal. And what do you think about that? Like, did you see which player surprised you the most for the Habs?
I was impressed with Joshua Roy. The guy had an insane game. I think it's insane. He showed so much progression. He was a fifth round pick in 2021, and now he's showing some insane things. What a pass on the Armia goal that we're about to see now on the highlight video. And also, I think he does every detail right. He's getting better game after game, and that's unbelievable from a player. Sometimes it takes time to adapt when you're a player that was picked in the later rounds and you start in the NHL. But Joshua Roy, I mean, look at those skills and look at that pass to Armia. Really good player. I'm so happy he's part of the future for the Habs. I think he's going to be a good top six option to complement or good players or even play in the bottom six. He's the kind of guy who can play every line. But what other players were you impressed by yesterday?
Man, what about Cole Caulfield? Five goals in the last five games. Like, wow.
Yeah, and I think the TVA Sport commentator, he said that he's the youngest player since Steve Schott to score a goal in five games in a row. That's completely insane. Shows all his talent, and he's back. I was never worried about him. He's a natural goal scorer, and I'm so glad we have him on the Habs. What a steal that guy was at 14th overall. I'm really happy about Cole, as always. I want to talk about the defense. I think Struble, he struggled against the Bruins. He made a couple of mistakes, probably his worst game, maybe because he was playing against his hometown team. But I think that's part of their learning process. Same goes with Monty. Yeah. He had a rough game. He played a really good week. I was so impressed the way he moves. And I think that if he was on a better team, I'm not even lying, this guy's top five, the Zena candidate. I'm not even exaggerating. Yeah. It's insane how much he can steal games. But yeah, obviously against the Bruins, it was really, really rough for him.
Yeah, so let's move on to the prediction of the week. We play the Ottawa Senators on Tuesday at the Bell Center. And then we play the New York Islanders.
Oh, yeah. Patrick Roy is also going to be playing his first game against Montreal. Well, coaching.
At the Bell Center. And then we visit the Pittsburgh Penguins and Sidney Crosby at Pittsburgh. What do you think? What do you think is going to be the predictions for you for the week?
I think this is going to be a rough week. Obviously, I think we don't really play a team in the top 10. We play three teams actually that are not even in a playoff spot. So maybe it's going to be a little bit, like, it's not going to be that hard, but it's the National Hockey League. Every game's hard. I think we're going to lose to the Ottawa Senators in overtime. I think we're still going to play a tight game because, like, you know, we're just going to want to have a revenge. And against the Islanders in Roy's first game, I also think we're going to show emotion, but I think we're also going to lose in overtime. So I think 2 points. I know I always predict that they lose in overtime. I just always think they can play close but lose. And then against the Pittsburgh Penguins, I think we're going to lose in regulation because we're playing away against Crosby. They're going to be motivated. They're fighting for the playoffs. It's the trade deadline soon. They want to prove that they can still be in the playoff race by the deadline, so they keep Gensel, guys like that. So I think we get 2 points out of six this week. What about you?
Okay, so me, I think we're going to win versus Ottawa. I think the Boers are really going to be mad and want to go for revenge. So I think we're going to win there. Then versus the Islanders, I think it's going to be pretty tough. We're going to lose. But then Saturday, I think, you know, it's Saturday night. Why not get a point in overtime? So I say we get 3 points out of six.
Wow, I would like that. So, yeah. And also, before we move on to our next topic, I want to say a last thing on the Habs. So now with Tanner Pearson coming back next week,
Yeah.
We're going to have to scratch two players. Who would you scratch? Because I
Listen,
guess we're
man,
going to keep Joshua Roy. So who do we scratch for
yeah.
Pearson?
Yo, to me, I don't even care if we lose Mitchell Stevens to waivers, but that guy has to go. That guy has to, like, I don't even know if he's playing for the Habs. Like, I never see him on the ice.
I agree.
Yeah.
Like, listen, Mitchell
Like,
Stevens, I don't get how he played over Ilonen. This is criminal. I don't get how he can play Stevens over Ilonen. It's ridiculous. So personally, I would scratch Stevens and Pezzetta,
I
but I don't
think
know
it's just
about you.
because. Yeah, I think it's just because he's a center, but like, yeah,
Good
at
point,
the
good
end of
point.
the day, like,
But like,
yeah, but Andrew,
yeah.
he's not even visible on the ice.
Yeah, call it Elias Anderson also. I'm not even kidding, maybe if we need a center, but yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see about that. It's gonna be interesting. So now let's move on to the next topic. We've had a breaking news in the National Hockey League yesterday. Patrick Roy is back in the NHL. Wow, that is like when I
Wow.
heard that on the radio, I lost my mind. That's completely
I
crazy. What
got
do you
the
think about
chills.
this hire
I
for
got the
the
chills.
Islanders? What?
I got the chills.
Yeah. So what did you think about that? What do you think was
Yeah,
gonna bring to this?
I think Patrick Roy is a really good coach. You know, we all know he was a very good goaltender. But I really think like the Islanders really need a guy like Roy. Like he's really gonna help this team. I really hope like, you know, the Islanders, you know, it's been ups and downs this season, you know. You can see them, they're fighting for a playoff.
He's a guy that's not gonna let things go easily. You know, when they make a mistake, he's not gonna be happy. He's gonna be mad. He's a tough coach. I think that's really important in the National Hockey League to have a tough coach who can be real with you and who can make tough decisions, even if it can hurt. If it sometimes it hurts people. But I still think sometimes it's the National Hockey League. You gotta talk to these players so they take you seriously. But yeah, I think Roy's a great coach, and that's insane. Imagine like you go in the dressing room before a game and you see Patrick Roy. Like that's insane. He's like the best
Yeah,
goaltender
man.
in NHL
Wow.
history. So
Yeah.
like, imagine having that guy as a coach talking to you. How much it can boost your morale? It's a bit like when we
Yeah.
hired Martin St-Louis. I think it's crazy. Like players see a thing like that. I think it's a huge spark.
Yeah, 100%. So yeah, let's move on to Corey Perry rumors to be signing with Edmonton.
Wow, I think that's oh my God, that's gonna be insane. Like Corey Perry and Connor McDavid on the same team. Like,
Yeah.
remember Prime Corey Perry? That guy, I'm pretty sure he had a couple of 50 goal seasons. And like now you're seeing him on McDavid. Obviously, he's not in his prime anymore, but it's still gonna be fun to see when someone hits Gallagher is aggressive towards him, he's gonna be able to like he's not gonna take that. You know, he's gonna hit, he's gonna fight. And I think he's the
Yeah.
perfect player for a cup. I think if you win the cup, you can't pass on having a chance to get a guy like Perry. And I think Perry, he
Yeah.
had interest from teams like the Panthers, the Lightning, but he still chose Edmonton. So I think he believes in the team. Yeah, wow, that's gonna be really fun to
Yeah,
watch. What do you think?
I really think like Edmonton's really needs this. Like they need a veteran guy that can go in there. You know, Perry is a guy that went to a lot of like playoff actions and like he has a lot of experience. He went to finals. So like I really think a guy like him to Edmonton is really gonna help the guys in that locker room.
Yeah, and I think Edmonton lacks a bit of that because sometimes in the playoffs in recent years, we've seen the team have a couple of rough games and people and having and missing people who are physical, who can fight and who can hit and can be dirty. You know, just play a dirty game. I think that's so important for Edmonton. And that guy went to three Stanley Cup finals with Montreal, Dallas, then Montreal, and then Tampa Bay. Lost all three. So
Yeah,
is
I have a
Edmonton gonna
question.
lose again in the Cup final? I don't know, but I still think
Yeah.
if they can just get to the Cup final, that's gonna be a huge achievement for them. But what do you
Yeah,
want to say
also,
also?
I have a question for you. Like, after, let's say they sign Corey Perry, do you think like Zach Hyman and him should be this both of them on the power play in front of the net?
Oh wow, yeah, that's a hell of a question. Ooh, who's gonna be in front of the net? That's actually a really good question because Hyman's been scoring so much this year. He's been one of the best goal scorers in the league because like he gets the job done. He goes in front of the net to dirty areas. So it's gonna be interesting to see what they do with their power plays. Perhaps they change up after 1 minute. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I really don't know. That's why I asked you, but yeah, let's move on to the All-Star game selections.
So
Who do you want? Who do you want? Nick Suzuki to go
before answering
with?
that question, I would say how much I appreciate this. This is insane. You're gonna have NHL stars with famous people who are known around the world. I mean, Justin Bieber, the
Yeah.
singer, Tate McRae also. Will Hartnett is a Netflix presenter, and also Michael Bublé. So you have some famous guys. They're going to be sponsoring this league. Who they're going to be, you know.
Like, it's going to be so fun.
That's going to be wild. And to answer your question, who I want to see with Suzuki, I want to see him with McKinnon and Tate McRae. Tate McRae has been promoting hockey. She's from Calgary. She watches some Flames games, so I think that's good. And also, he gets a chance to play with Nathan MacKinnon, who's in my opinion, Nathan MacKinnon's the best player this year. He's so clutch. Like, whenever he plays in the playoffs, he's always like shows up for this team. He's dangerous. He's always everywhere. I think to win one cup, if you ask me right now, who would I take to start my franchise this year to win a cup, it's MacKinnon. And also the assistant captain, big Cale Makar, who became the second fastest defenseman in NHL history to hit 300 points. So I want to see Suzuki on Team MacKinnon. What about you?
Yeah, me too, man. Like, exactly what you said. You know, MacKinnon is really a tough guy. You know, he's that guy, you know. And I really think it will be fun to watch Suzuki Makar together. Like, that's going to be just awesome.
Oh, wow. And if Suzuki, I don't want it to be with Austin Matthews, Morgan Riley, Justin Bieber, because, like, I don't like the Leafs and I don't like just Justin Bieber either. But also, it wouldn't bother me if he's with McDavid.
Yeah. So, okay, let's move on to Saturday game review. You know, we all know, you know, Boston had a dominant win versus the Habs. And then, you know, we could see, what do you think about this, man? Toronto shot 46 shots and only scored 4 goals, but the Canucks shot 21 shots and won the game with a score of 6-4.
So, I don't know what is going on with the Maple Leafs. They have lost 5 of the last 6 games. But also, I think a big reason they've been bad recently, John Tavares. Will you believe me?
Yeah.
I tell you, he hasn't had a point in his last 8 games, which is his longest streak of his career.
And you know what's crazy? He's paid $10 million.
Wow, like, yeah, even more. He's paid like $11 million. It's insane. I think that's a big reason why Toronto's been bad. But also, there are many other things. I think Sheldon Keefe, I said it before the season. I swear to God, I said that before the season. I don't understand how Sheldon Keefe can still be coaching this team. He's not bringing the best out of his players, yeah, out of his depth, and all those things. I also think it's going to get better for Toronto when Joseph Woll comes back from his injury, because Martin Jones and Elias Samsonov have been terrible. But yeah, what do you think about that?
Yeah, you know, man, I really don't understand this team of Toronto. Like, yes, Nylander scored and stuff, but, like, you know, John Tavares, man, like, what are you doing? I'd rather have Michael Pezzetta than you, man.
Okay, well, we still have a couple of minutes left, which brings me to the next subject. So, the Edmonton Oilers, wow, what is going on? They won 13 games in a row, beating a record of the most wins in a row by the Canadian team. They beat their own record of the Canadians in 1967. What is going on? How is this team so good?
Like, man, like, I remember in the start of the season, we were all like, oh my God, Edmonton, what happened? But now, all of a sudden, like, wow.
Yeah,
they're suddenly the 11th in the league. I remember they were like 31st. Like, this is crazy
and
to me.
The thing,
go ahead.
Yeah, the thing is, Connor McDavid is not even that producing that much. I mean, he's good, but there are other players stepping up. Warren Fogle has had himself a 5-point game recently, and also a 4-point game one time. So I don't know how he's that good. Maybe it has to do with playing with Dry, but also Stuart Skinner. For me, that's the key factor. They finally have a good goaltender. Skinner struggled early in the season. Recently, he's been one of the best goalies in the league. So I think, like, that's a huge reason why Edmonton's so good right now. All right, so we got it. Hurry up there. There's 45 seconds left. So let's talk about Steven Stamkos, like 15 seconds. Do you think he's signing with Tampa at the end of the season or no?
No, I think he's moving on to another team and going to a Stanley Cup team.
Okay.
Now, let's go on to the question of the day. We all saw the Bruins mocked us. They said they set the holy holy. They started doing waves. Do we accept that in Montreal?
No, we don't. I think that's ridiculous. I mean, you're doing this against a rebuilding team. Do you realize that? That's pathetic, you know? That's pathetic. Focus on your own team. But you choked last year to the Florida Panthers in 7 games after winning the president. You guys completely, you guys are a dumpster fire. I mean, you choke every... If you hadn't won that cup in 2011, you would be absolutely nothing. So I don't understand why you guys are doing this. This is ridiculous. Stop copying your thing.
Yeah.
Get your own thing.
Yeah. So, yeah, guys, thank you so much.
Shout out to Sammy.